In this video, we are going to understand the manufacture of fertilizer, that is ammonium phosphate. Ammonium phosphate is also known as ortho ammonium phosphate or ortho phosphate, and it is the salt of ammonia and phosphate ion. It is water soluble, and the aqueous solution on boiling loses ammonia. And ammonium phosphates basically are of two types: monoammonium phosphate or MAP and diammonium phosphate, that is DAP. In monoammonium phosphate, the nitrogen content is 11 to 12%, and in diammonium phosphate, that is DAP, the nitrogen content is 16 to 18%. And the raw materials are nothing but ammonia and H3PO4, that is phosphoric acid. Now, without wasting time, let us proceed further and know the process of ammonium phosphate manufacturing. So you can see the three reactors over here. These three reactors are nothing but in these reactors phosphoric acid and ammonia reaction occurs. How? Let us know. From the topmost portion, a pipe is there. From this, H3PO4 is added. And from beneath of the tower, we add ammonia. The reaction occurs in the reactor 1, and this reaction yields monoammonium phosphate. And monoammonium phosphate is present over here. It can be further dried and can be used as a fertilizer. But if we need a fertilizer of higher nitrogen content, that is diammonium phosphate, we need to proceed to two more processes, that is with reactor 2 and reactor 3. In reactor 2, the slurry which we get from the reactor 1 is exempt, more phosphoric acid is added, and more anhydrous ammonia is sent to it, so that the monoammonium phosphate reacts with it and gives us diammonium phosphate or triammonium phosphate. Now the slurry from this goes to the reactor 3 also, and then more higher content of nitrogen containing fertilizer is prepared over here. Now the whole reaction is done, but further it has to be dried. So from beneath, KCl is added, and this KCl is mixed with the slurry in the reactor 3. This slurry is finally mixed with KCl in the granulator. It is a rotary drum granulator where it is finally absorbed from the KCl in a bed of dry recycled fertilizer moving through a rotating drum granulator. Now the slurry has to be dried so as to be used in the form of a fertilizer. It has to be dried nicely, so the slurry is sent to a dryer. A rotary adiabatic dryer reduces the moisture to less than 1% with 10 minute contact time with air, initially at temperature of about 1500 degrees Celsius. So at such high temperatures, the molten slurry, or not molten exactly, it is a slurry that is in solution form, slightly concentrated. So it is dried at temperature of about 1500 degrees Celsius. But yet, now the process is not yet over, it has to be packed. So it is finally screened. About screening, vibrational screens are used. A double decker screen is used over here. And we have already learned this in unit operations. A screen is used so as to separate or segregate the different levels of the ammonium phosphate crystals. So the dried product is separated into three fractions on a double deck screen. A portion of the product from the deck of the lower screen, that is from the deck of the lower screen, is sent for the bagging operations. Now it is the most bottom one will contain the finest fertilizer. That is why it is sent for bagging operations. So let us quickly revise whatever we have read now. The raw material is H3PO4 and NH3, ammonia and phosphoric acid. Ammonia is added from beneath and H3PO4 is added from the topmost level. The reaction occurs here. But what if we need a fertilizer of higher nitrogen content? Therefore, again the slurry is taken into a reactor 2 and 3 respectively, and ammonia is added again. Then the slurry in the reactor 3 is mixed with KCl, and the reaction again takes place in the granulator. The absorption takes place and it gets absorbed by the granules in the granulator. Again, the slurry goes into the dryer, and at a temperature of about 1500 degrees Celsius, it is dried with air. After drying, it is separated from the double deck screen and is sent for packaging. The lower level product is sent for packaging and bagging operations. So this is all about the ammonium phosphate manufacturing.